Wait, the file with all the passwords is where? It's questions like that that make me love tabletop exercises. And it makes me reinforce my idea that tabletop exercises are extremely important for every organization to run. In this series, I'm going to be talking about tabletop exercises, why you should be doing them, how you can do them, and what are the tips and tricks to make sure that your organization can do them as well as they can, and to grow and to improve as the result of running them. My name is Jordan M. Schroeder, and I am the Managing CISO at Hephaestis. I've been running tabletop exercises in one form or another for many years. So what is a tabletop exercise? Now, in this series, I'll be using the term TTX to describe tabletop exercises because that's how I think of them in my head. So a TTX is where you sit down with a scenario and you hash out what would happen in your organization with your people, your processes, your technology. What would happen if that scenario played out for real in your organization? I have seen a variety of different types of TTX. I have seen completely automated TTX. I have seen TTX being run with, you know, professional actors and, you know, pre-recorded media clips, and they're a multi-day thing. I've never seen them work really well. But I have seen tabletop exercises that are half hour long. Bring everybody in for just 30 minutes, throw an idea on a table, and everyone try to hash it out. I've seen those work magically, just absolute magic. So there's a variety of different things that you can do with your tabletop exercises and how you can run them. My preference is what's known as theater of the mind, where a question is posed, everyone imagines what would have happened, and there's a facilitator to help guide that theater of the mind and just try to keep everyone on track and keep the scope a little constrained, because things can go really broad and go into weird directions very quickly because it's all in everyone's imagination. But you first want to figure out what the scenario is. And the typical one is that you're going to want to do in terms of cybersecurity is probably phishing or ransomware. Between these two things, these are the most common attacks that every organization will see. So you need to have very exercised and very practiced response to that. So start with the scope of like some kind of a phishing scenario or some kind of a ransomware scenario. And then at what level? Do you want to tackle this at a management level? If it's severe enough that management needs to get involved? Does it need to be in the tactical level to know how to run the scenario while it's evolving? Or do you want it purely as an operational exercise? What do we do if we no longer have these files, these machines, these backups, or what happens when a critical account has been compromised? And try to keep a very, very clear scope. So what's the basic scope that we want to test? Is it management? Is it strategic? Is it tactical or operational? And what's the type of thing we want to be exercising? Ransomware or phishing being the examples. You then pull in the participants based on that scope, right? So if you are dealing with a management level, then you're probably going to need management people, right? And if you're dealing with operational things, you need to deal with operational people. But as you pull those people in, make sure you also bring in at least one person from the other groups. If you're in a purely management scope, bring in someone who's operational. They may not say much, they may not be an active participant, but you want to have them there just in case. And in the same way, you want a management person attending an operational TTX so that there is always this cross-pollination of ideas and you've got this awareness that's happening. Now, the management person might not be saying much, but they'll be learning a ton during this exercise as well. So once you've got your scope, you've got your participants, now you start pulling out what your scenario is actually going to look like. And if you're just starting out, or if your organization is new to this, or they haven't matured in their response processes, you want to be dealing with the simplest of scenarios. And it could simply be ransomware has hit this computer or this server, and that's it. That may be an impactful enough scenario and cause as much uncertainty and as much chaos as your organization or your participants can handle at that moment, and you just leave it at that. You could get pre-packaged scenarios with multiple levels of mutating situations and different things get pulled in, You can get those things. They're available for free. You can purchase packages. There's lots out there where people have thought about what the scenarios would look like. I like to keep things extremely simple when you start, and you build the complexity as this exercise, as you're the people, as the processes, as your organization matures in their ability to run tabletop exercises. And if it turns out that your organization is able to handle that particular scenario quite simply, then you start adding in these complications. And those complications are known as injects. You have a scenario, and now your scenario mutates, something changes. And once you've run a scenario, then what's the outcome? What's the best possible outcome from a tabletop exercise? There are two things that I say that are the best outcomes. One, lessons learned. Anytime you run an incident, you want to be able to capture those lessons learned. What did we do well? What didn't we do well? What gaps have we identified? What do we need to fill? If you're doing those on a regular basis, and you should, on a normal live incident, you can do that same process in a tabletop exercise, and you get the benefits of getting these lessons learned without something actually going wrong. I mean, nothing's at risk in a tabletop exercise. The second best outcome from a tabletop exercise is an understanding of what reality looks like for your organization. Imagine that in a scenario, your organization has done everything well. There's been no gaps, there's no weaknesses, all the processes worked, all the people responded in an appropriate way, the technology worked as it expected, and even with some injects and some twisting of this scenario, things happened well. If everything worked the way it was supposed to, you're still going to have an impact to the organization. And knowing what that impact is, even when things go well, is your baseline for reality. This is what this scenario looks like for us. And unless we have an overhaul of our people, process, and technology, this is what it's going to look like. And knowing that that's the outcome, it's extremely valuable for management in order to manage risk and to set expectations that this is what we're going to experience. And there's nothing wrong, nothing has gone wrong if we experience that. And that's an extremely important outcome from a tabletop exercise. Oh yeah. Remember that password file? That question was asked by someone in management in the middle of a tactical tabletop exercise. And everyone had put in all these processes to protect the systems and protect the accounts, but this password file was in an unexpected location. Everyone knew about it. No one talked about it. No one wanted to deal with the fact that it existed. But in the middle of a tabletop exercise, it suddenly got laid out on the table. And a tabletop exercise is a great place for these things to come out, and not in the middle of an incident. And that's why I love tabletop exercises.